It's always an exciting time of year, just 4 days away now from opening day, and it's a great time to relive memories of seasons past. WLWT News 5's Christy Davis has a look at the best way to do just that inside the Reds Hall of Fame.
You know, there are a lot of memories that go along with being a Reds fan, and this year, some of those memories are new. They're inside the Reds Hall of Fame. If you come with us, we're going to give you a sneak peek.
When is a jersey not just a jersey? Would it belong to a king of the Queen City?
Takes you back to those Riverfront Stadium days and many people's great memories, fond memories of going to a ball game.
In this ever-changing part of the Hall of Fame, you'll find recent treasures.
Joey has given us, at least temporarily, his MVP award from 2010. So to win a National League MVP is a very special award.
Get a glimpse of the final out caught in two different World Series and the garments of legends.
So he is the king of the Queen City when it comes to hitting. So with 4,256 hits, I don't think you could have a better guy. He's also a hometown Red.
Which is where the newest exhibit picks up, hometown Reds.
Played youth baseball here and really were products of what this great sport and this great town bring together.
Favorite sons like Ken Griffey Jr. populate the exhibit. You learn fun trivia like the fact that only 105 Reds players in the ball club's history actually came from Cincinnati.
It's a great exhibit to inspire the young to get out there, and if you love the game of baseball, just follow guys like Pete Rose and Ken Griffey Jr.
A reminder of what baseball means to the city ahead of what many fans see as the real start and hope of spring.
Because in the spring, especially before opening day, everybody's undefeated.
So this year, before the first pitch, you might want to stop by the Reds Hall of Fame. And who knows, when you go to the game, you could be watching a future inductee. From the Reds Hall of Fame, Christy Davis, WLWT News 5.